Hello and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas and today we're going to talk about logical replication improvements in Postgres 15. In this blog post by Amit Kapila, he describes some of these logical replication features that were improved in Postgres 15. He starts out by talking about prepared transactions. If you're not familiar, prepared transactions or two-phase commit is usually used when you have two servers where you're committing the data. You're trying to synchronize and make sure that either the transaction fails on both servers or it succeeds on both servers. You're not getting constraint violations on one of them, but not the other. The way you would use this with logical replication is that you first enable this two-phase equals true setting, and then this can be used to make sure that logical replication replicates the data at prepare time instead of at commit time. Now, you still have to do work to actually use this to build what Amit calls here a conflict-free logical replication architecture. Postgres doesn't necessarily take care of everything here for you, but it gives you an important building block to then be able to build an effective architecture. Next, he talks about a few ways how you can define better which data gets replicated in the replication stream. He starts out by a new setting that lets you define that all tables in a particular schema should be replicated. This saves you from having to list tables manually. You could have done something like this previously, but previously when the schema got new tables added, you would have to go back and add them later manually. Now this new option does it automatically. So when a new table gets created, it automatically gets added to the replication stream. On a subscriber, you do have to make sure that the table exists. So this does not replicate PDL. This just makes sure that the replication stream contains the data, but you do have to make sure that the table definitions are updated ahead of time. And there's two improvements on how to filter the data in the tables that are being replicated. First of all, there are row filters. Row filters are simple expressions that are applied to the data in the replication stream, and they can do things like saying this column needs to be larger than its value, or this column needs to match this like text expression. It lets you select a subset of your data and just direct that data to your replica. There are important restrictions here, and the most important one that I would note is that the update and deletes that go into your replication stream will only contain what's referred to as a replica identity. Usually that would be the primary key. The replica identity is something you can set on a per table basis. If you are setting a row filter, that row filter needs to include the replica identity columns only because of the way how this is built inside Postgres. In this particular example, if I have updates on this table here, I would have to make sure that both C1 and C2 are included in a replica identity. The other thing that was added were column lists. Previously, you always had to replicate the whole table, not a subset of columns. And sometimes that is not desirable. For example, imagine you have a users table, you want to replicate the metadata, but you don't really want to replicate your hash password field. With Postgres 15, you can now restrict which columns get replicated. Similar to the row filters, you also still have to make sure that your column lists include the replica identity, because otherwise Postgres wouldn't be able to identify which column an update or delete is referring to. Now, there are a couple of other improvements here. The one I find quite noteworthy here is how logical replication deals with errors. If you've used logical replication in production, you probably ran into a problem where you added a column and you forgot to do that on your subscriber side. Postgres 15 has a better way of dealing with errors like that and others. First of all, it lets you define a way how to turn off replication of a subscription when there are errors. You can say disable on error true. What that means is that the subscription will actually stop trying to repeat the exact same error again and again when it hits an error the first time, and you can go in and fix it. There is also a better way to skip transactions. So let's say for some reason you have data that conflicts with what's on the subscriber side, you're okay with skipping over the bad data. Now there is a new way to skip a particular LSN explicitly. There's some additional safety checks that let you make that more easily without running into a couple of problems. Last but not least, there is an improvement in terms of statistics tracking and monitoring. There's a new pgstats subscription stats view. If you look at that more closely, there's really two main things here for each subscription that you have. There's the apply error count and the sync error count. Sync would apply at the initial synchronization time, and apply would apply when the replication stream runs and when you run into errors. The scenario that I've seen often in production is that you mess something up, you forget something, and then suddenly the replication breaks and errors start happening on the subscriber. This is where I would watch out for this apply error count becoming non-zero or being incrementing from the previous count, because that would mean that there is something that needs my attention and I need to go in and fix it. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.